Hey everybody, and we are back, and we're doing Starting Mermaid, and we're going to start with this merman right here out of Mythomorphia. It is in the back of the book, so I say where you find the kind of the kind of hidden items where that page is, it would be the third from the back page of that. So anyway, it's in the back. So we're gonna do this merman, and we're gonna make him aerial colors. So he's gonna be green and red. So let's get started. I think most of you know, if you've have snuck and watched any of my pictures, and not snuck, but just glanced by, that I do dark skin tones, mostly because that's what I'm comfortable with, and also because I don't have skin colors to do it now that it's skin tone. We're going to call him Ari. We're going to drop the L from Ariel. Let's call him Ari. Fix it. And what we're going to do with the bubbles is we're going to just go over them lightly, and that'll make it look transparent over the skin. And then when we do this area, I got to think about it a little bit. I'm not sure what I'm going to do with that. I'm not going to draw in any backgrounds on this. I'm going to just leave it how it is. Yeah, that's gonna be just that. So right now we're using brown and we just gonna shade in fine places, and where it's a lot of hash marks, we're gonna do darker, and when it's just a little bit, we're just gonna fade it out a little bit. And usually I would go in and do something with the scales, but I don't want to make them look like pimples, so I'm going to leave them alone. Okay. They can hear you, babe. Yeah, well, I'm not live, but I'm recording. You can just talk regularly because that this little mic here can pick up music all the way back there.
Okay.
Yeah.
You just gonna for music?
No. I'm gonna straight upload this. No editing. I want him to be brown, so I'm gonna go back over my dark spots, my dark areas with cappuccino. That way I can make him brown. So let's just go over it one more time. The cappuccino is a little darker brown, and that way I can make him brown. Well, I already went over it. We'll fix that later. So now I'm just gonna go in lightly with brown with the lightest pressure I can do. And I'm gonna also go over those bubbles. And we won't touch those bubbles again. We'll leave those alone. And that way it'll look transparent after we do the second layer of brown. And so I am drinking coffee this morning. It is Starbucks coffee, and it will be the last Starbucks coffee that I drink with everything that has been going on with Starbucks. I just will not be drinking any more Starbucks coffee, but I have already had this coffee before, you know, I knew about whatever everything was going on, because I've had this coffee for a month. I'm going to drink it because I paid for it, but it will be the last coffee, she's fine with me because I'm a Dunkin' Donuts girl anyway. So we will be drinking Dunkin' Donuts. Folgers is still pretty good, and they have a whole bunch of flavors. So, you know, not missing out on anything. But that's what I'm drinking right now. And then maybe later on in the day, when we do a part two, it may be wine. And again, we're just doing the lightest pressure. I'm doing the lightest pressure I can because I want to go over this with Crazy Art. You can't do a, when you're trying to do skin tone, I feel like it's best to do several layers instead of trying to do the color that you want right away. And it seems to make it so that it's less streaky. And the color seems to come out better that way. But it takes you longer. So if you're impatient, then, you know, Crazy Arts is not a pencil for someone who wants a blended effect or a layered effect, but is impatient. You would be better off probably with the softcore pencil in that case, because you just can't get a blended effect in your first shot with these pencils. Maybe you can with the hardcore pencils that are more expensive. I don't know. I don't have any. But I found patience. I can have patience with a pencil if I'm paying only $5 for it, you know? Seems like a small price to pay. It just take a little more time. Alright. I wasn't sure how he was going to come out, but I actually am happy with it. We're going to go over the lips and everything. We're gonna worry, obviously, the whites of his eyes. We're gonna make sure we get those eyelids. Alright. Can you, I don't know if this is showing up on camera, but the first thing is always a little, is light, and it looks a little, washed out because the paper is still showing through, and that's why we gotta go over it again, and this is just our base layer. Mm-hmm. See how he looks very defined and chiseled out. And now we're gonna take wait a minute. Now I'm doing toasted toffee. And we're just gonna go in. And now we're trying to. We're just gonna go in and give him that color that I'm looking for. Over the dark areas too. So we're just gonna go over all of the skin. Then if you need to darken anything up, you can still do that. I'm gonna leave those bubbles alone for now. There are a couple of other people doing mermaid on Instagram, so if you want to check that out, it's going to be, you know, hashtag mermaid, and you can see everybody's pictures. And these are also the colors that I use sometimes. Well, this color, toasted toffee, when I want to do gold. But we may not use him for gold. This color for gold, we might just use our lightest brown, but we probably end up using this. I'm not sure. Depends on how gold I want the gold to look. I have a gold pencil, but that gold pencil doesn't look anything like gold. Looking too bad. I'm gonna make that. I went over, but and that's probably still part of his body, but well, yeah, it's his arm. So well, yeah, I know I messed up, but I did it. That's his arm. See, if we didn't do that first layer, this wouldn't have came out like that. It would have came out a lighter, washed out version of what we did with the brown. So it's best to do a base layer and then go over it. And we could have went over it again with brown. But I tend to do a dark base layer and then go over it with a lighter color. And then these bubbles, I still want them to look transparent, so I'm gonna go in with Peridot, which I don't think I'm pronouncing it right. It might be Peridot, it might be French, Peridot. Or something like that, but I'm just gonna go with that lightest color, that way it remains transparent. See? So it just looks like a water bubble. But let's go back with our toffee and finish off this skin. And this may, doing the skin may just be our first part, maybe. We may be able to get another element in this video. Is that just hand? I love this hand, but this one, we don't do brown, but this one here, we might do toasted toffee and this part here, and then do that brown, because that's the underside of his hand. And when we go, we're gonna go over his face probably one more time, but we're gonna leave the lips. We're not gonna darken them. I got my first book for my birthday haul. And then I'm also going to look into getting some PDF books. I know Etsy is a good place for that, but I also need to look on ColorTube and find if there's other places that do PDF versions of books. And even though it's my birthday, I still on a budget, so you know. some of the PDFs that I want, I can just get the paperback version for that, but I guess the PDF would be better because I could go, I'm gonna go in with this brown and get this here. I can always reprint a page if I mess up. Much need to pick me up. Okay. So, it's looking good if I do say so myself. And when we're done with him, we're gonna go next door and we're gonna do the mermaid. And if we finish that, which we should, because this isn't, it's not a very complicated page, it doesn't look like. So we should be able to finish the mermaid as well. So if we finish that, then we will also go in a couple of pages, and there's a siren. And we will do her too, because a siren is just a more monster looking mermaid, mer person, let's say that, mer monster maybe. At any rate, this mermaid, so we're gonna do it if we get have the time to do it. For June, I don't know. I may do a video of, I'm waiting on when I get my books to do a video for the whole year so we can plan out what we're gonna do. But for June, I will probably do a page out of one of my coloring books I get for my birthday. So we have our second layer. So now what I want to go do is I want to go in cappuccino, and I just want to darken up. Well, no. Let's backpedal for a minute. When we're gonna do cappuccino, we're gonna get this gap here. Okay, and then we're gonna go with our brown. I'm gonna darken up some of these areas here. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna sketch the tip of this finger here and that edge. Fade it out a little bit. And then we're just gonna color this whole part here. Okay. And now, with toffee, we're gonna go over bring that color out. I made his hands darker than his body. I'm gonna go over his body again anyway, because I do want him a little darker. So we're gonna take brown and we're gonna go over his hand, light. Like, take toffee. And then this underside of the hand, we're gonna use our Peridot. And we're gonna just catch that, because that's the underside of his hand. And then we're gonna go over it again. With toffee. I'm darkening it a little bit. Really gonna darken it up in that crease right there. And fade that out. And that's pretty good. Now, I got some time, so we're gonna go back in with cappuccino, and I wanna darken up his chin area really quick. Where the crease is, we're doing dark pressure, heavy pressure, and then we fade it out. Just in another video, I have work today, so we're gonna get as much done. Sundays, especially once people get out of church, so, and because it's just now becoming warm and sunny out, there'll be a lot of people coming in buying charcoal and things to grill out and barbecue, so, it'll be a busy day. I don't have a whole shift, so I'm not gonna complain about it. But with me not having a whole shift, that probably means I'm gonna be doing a bunch of breaks and lunches for people. Almost done. Would have been done in the first place if I just stuck to what I was going to do originally in my head, but then once I got to the page, I changed my mind. And I should have stuck with it. So, that was Cappuccino. We're going to go over him with that brown, and we're going to darken him up a little bit. I just feel like he would look a little better, a tad bit darker. So, that's what I'm gonna do. And so, yep, that was the right choice to make. I like this better. All right. I figured the first part would be skin, so, and that was right, because once we were done with this here, this will be part one, and part two we will tackle his lower body and hair. And I'm wondering if I'm gonna do colorful fish or am I gonna do just the monochromatic color scheme and just do shades of the same color. I've just talked myself into doing monochromatic. Well, not necessarily monochromatic, but a limited color palette on this page, which is also what I did with our Lovebird page, that I still have a lot on that page that I haven't finished off camera. So I will be working on that. Well, yeah, I'm gonna work on that off camera. I will still leave enough to do a part four, a final video. Because there's quite a lot to do. And if I were to do it on camera, it would probably end up being about 6 parts. And I want to keep that to 4 parts, because it's mostly leaves. Not any of the good stuff, you know. And if we weren't doing mermaid, if I didn't have a theme this month, I wouldn't care about having the 6 parts of that. But because I'm trying to do 3 pages this month on camera, and we're just going to leave that as a 4-part series. So I gotta make sure I don't forget about this hand here. So I was on Kirby Roman's page Twitter, and he had a picture of I can't remember the name of the creature, but it's from Filipino mythology. And it was really pretty, like a dragon-like creature with sword feathers. A follower of his, you know, made the comment of, I hope that you're, well, asked him, are you going to do a book of Filipino mythology creatures? And I had to like that comment because I hope so. It's like I said, he said that Geomorphia was his final book. And I'm hoping that he meant that that was his final book with that publisher and not that that is his final book ever. So hopefully he decides to go to another publisher if he's not happy with the publisher that he has. And, because he got a lot of backlash for Phantomorphia, and I saw it for the first time in the store, and I can see why people are upset. It's the same amount of money. It's not the same amount of pages. It's very thin. The pictures itself, the images itself are very pretty. I like them, but it's just for the money, you're not getting as many images. It should be half the price. And I think if had it been half the price, or even, half the price, then people wouldn't have been so upset. But to charge, for the publisher to charge the same amount of money as his other books for less pages, that's where the backlash, I feel, came from. I did tweet the publisher. They said that they did not address the issue of how many pages were in the book. They only addressed the reason they had it one-sided was because people had been commenting on that they wanted one-sided book of his so that they could use their markers, which I understand, but they didn't comment on the fact that, on the other part that I was told them I was upset about there being less images in the book for the amount of money that they were charging. They didn't have any, they conveniently, dismiss that part, I suppose. So, that's that. I also reached out to Crazy Arts. Told them I think that they should do a 74 count pencil box with two white pencils and two black pencils. And I did that for continuity, but I should have told them three black pencils and one white pencil, because you're really kind of not going to use the white pencil as much, because the white pencil is not really for blending anything out too much, even though you can use it, and I've used it and it works okay, but it's definitely something that you would have to use Crazy Ops pencils a lot to know how to use it. But they said they would think about it, so maybe that will be coming soon. That's my updates on that. And I have a book blog that I am converting to a, I don't know if I'm going to, I haven't read a lot since I've started coloring. I haven't read at all, really. And I probably will get back into reading, but now I'm considering, do I change my book blog into a color blog, or do I just add my coloring into my book blog? I'm thinking I'm going to add my coloring into my book blog, and so that I can start reading again. And I think my goal will be to have maybe read a book every 2 weeks. And that way I can still color as much as I'm coloring, but then I will force myself to read at least a book every 2 weeks. Now, Shalene, she has, I follow her on ColorTube, and she reads a lot. And she has just as many hobbies as me. I don't know how she is able to do as many hobbies as she does, but she figures out a way. I don't think that will be me. I enjoy coloring a whole lot more than I do any other hobby. And it's more affordable. I'm gonna be honest with you. It's more affordable. Once you have your pencils and your book, that's all you need. When you have yarn, you have to buy yarn. When you have crochet and knitting, you have to have yarn. You have to, and it takes more time to get the pieces out. So I'll do that. But I think knitting and crochet will be my personal hobby for items I want to wear myself. And maybe I get a little more enjoyment out of it anyway, because it was something that I did actually for as a small business. And it just, sometimes when you do things as a business that was once a hobby, it takes the fun out of it when it's something that requires so much time and effort. And you don't really get what you put into it. And that is what knitting is and crochet was for me, because I'm not a fast knitter. And I wasn't getting my money out of my knitting and crochet. I was making okay, but I wasn't making what I should have been making. I could not break into, it was just the amount of money it would have took to break into a higher end market, which is what I would have needed to do to make that sustainable. That's that. Because coloring just gets me, just relaxes me. I really enjoy it. It's my husband's fault. He brought me into it. I think he regrets it a little bit. But it's too late now. I'm about the joys of coloring. And he's in the other room reading the paper. And it's so weird to be on camera speaking with someone else within earshot, but you're not talking to anyone. You're talking to yourself in the camera, hoping someone's gonna, you know, watch the video and relate. It's weird, but what we color tubers do, right? Record and hope someone's watching. Hope someone says, hey, me too. So I'm doing the bubbles now, and I'm using toasted toffee to do that. And see how that just makes it a little transparent. I'm not going in dark with it. You want to just do light because you want it, that paper to kind of come through because it helps with that transparent effect. And I found this out by mistake because I colored, did another page and I colored it by mistake, and then I was like, oh, that makes it look like a bubble, because I was going to do the bubbles blue on the other page, and I just found out if you do this, it makes it better. So now I'll do this. All right, so now we have his skin, and that took a while, so that is our part one. So thank you all for watching. And we will be back with part two. Appreciate you.